Hello everybody, welcome back to Minecraft. My name is Tudanka and we are here beneath our base. And I brought you here, well, basically, for the moment, I'm just gathering deep slate for the smithy that we are about to build. But I discovered something and wanted to show you. Apparently, in my excavation, where's he gone? But dang, there was a slime here. Apparently, I've hit a slime chunk, which means we can finally get our hands on... I swear there was a slime here. Am I hallucinating, maybe? Maybe I should get rid of some of these torches and just wait for a little bit. Huh, well, every other kind of nastiness spawned here, but no slimes. I swear I saw one. Maybe the replay mod caught it, so I can show you. But this is something we'll have to work on in the future, because I think we can use slime. Hello, sir. You please go somewhere else. Now, before we get into building, I have a lot of stuff to show you, because I've been such a busy bee. You have no idea. I've been digging. A lot! And I wanted to show you the results on camera because I think there's nothing quite as satisfying as harvesting all of the goods you get in your cave. So let's see. Now, what of you? Oh, by the way, in case I didn't show you that, I have gotten a little tip regarding the oak trap doors between all the sugarcane. I exchanged them for, what is it, sandstone slabs? Yeah. So you basically don't see a difference in blocks there. Looks way smoother, I think. So thank you. Thank you very much. There's some other stuff to show you, but first of all, we have to manage this here. Holy moly. Let's take the almost, well, kind of broken silk touch in one hand and let's get going. I think you will never again need coal. Well, at least for a week. And not to forget, even the few redstone ores and emeralds shall be mined. Ooh, even got a level. Nice. Look at this. Oh, what was... Ma'am? Please, quiet, I'm recording. Now, this is quite a lot. Actually, the iron isn't that much. That looked way more in ore form. But the rest is okay-ish. That's quite the bounty, just from digging. Digging, by the way, into the direction of the mesa. I'm currently digging a tunnel that is, well, basically just a 4x4 tunnel that is currently not even halfway done, which is fine. I'm doing that in the background, and once it's done, I'm going to show you. But you get a lot of stuff out of a big old tunnel like that. So let's get us sorted. Now, there is so much other stuff I really want to show you. We actually have to convert the coal into coal blocks, otherwise the barrel cannot hold them. Okay, now, first of all, outside. I have been such a dum-dum in the last episode regarding the bees. Well, remember how I encased all of the, well, at that point, those two hives with spruce trapdoors all around them? Well, it doesn't work that way. basically the smoke from the campfire has to reach the beehive. It does that if there's one spruce trapdoor in the way. As soon as there's two, it doesn't work and the bees get angry. Now I can... Wait. Boop. 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 Hello. Hello, Miss Bee. Now, and I've been, of course, breeding them with flowers and crafting some additional beehives. Boop. And there's even a sixth one over yonder. Yeah. And we should actually have enough honey blocks now to get going with our build. Those were actually crucial, and I'll show you why in a few minutes. 25, that is a good amount. Now you guys, maybe you wanna make some love. Okay, that is good. I need more of you. Some of them escape and fly away and are, well, probably not able to come back, because every time I breed them, there seems to be one or two missing, which is actually fine. I have no trouble breeding them every now and then. Whoop. Did I get everyone? I think so. Look at the little bees. Such grace. Such majesty. Oh. Look at them. There's a big old bumblebee family over there. It's adorable. The other thing that I did in the off time was fill in this empty spot over here. Now, I actually wanted to build some other custom trees in here, but I thought, okay, you know what? This whole area is missing some sort of transport vehicle. So I built a little cart filled with pumpkins and melons and hay with, well, very round wheels, obviously. This is Minecraft, that's how you do here. Tilted forward a little bit. Yeah. Nothing currently inside, that's fine. This is just decoration. Yeah, I like it. Was a little bit of a pain to build, honestly, because I tried desperately to make somewhat roundish wheels, but that just doesn't work. Just always looks terrible. So that is that. Now, the other thing that I've been busy with, and it was... It actually didn't take me as long as I thought to do it. I have been zombifying all of those guys. Not once, but twice. Now, I've been brewing up all of those splash potions of weakness, and we are currently down to 8 golden apples, which means our gold reserves are dwindling, because I used a bunch of gold for golden apples for them, obviously. And it's about time we hit the mesa to grab all the gold we can. And yeah. So each and every one of them is zombified twice, which means all the important books now just cost a teeny tiny blink of what they've been costing before. One emerald, one book. This is awesome. And I've been, of course, because of that, thanks to that, fully enchanting everything that we have. There's just two enchants, I think, missing on the bow, whom I don't have a villager for, but we'll get there eventually. But every tool is done, the armor is done, it's all good and dandy. And actually, I wanted to show you something, just in case you didn't know how to really efficiently get XP through villages. Now, let's say you have your zombified and de-zombified enchanty boys and your brewing boys. Now, what you need is a few emeralds to begin with, and see if, well, for example, someone has the glass trait. Yes, we take all of them, thank you. Now, a little bit of XP goes into our eggs. And we do this with all the other guys that have the glass trait. In our case, that is 4 of them. Boop. And we still have a little bit of the original emeralds left. That is wonderful. Any XP still in here? Wait. Maybe he has glass again. Wonderful. Okay. Now, we craft those up to glass bottles. Yeah, now we switch to the hoe and the shovel because those are yet to be repaired. And the glass bottles we turn back into emeralds. And at the end of the day, we will generate a surplus. If we get rid of all the glass bottles. Not yet. We have to transform this glass also. You have refreshed your traits. Awesome. And we are out. Oh, actually, it's even. Oh, I didn't realize. I thought we were making a plus, but that should be doable if you keep zombifying them, because those price reductions stack. So we might not be able to get a better deal than one emerald for four glass, but we might be able to get a better deal than four glass bottles for one emerald. We might get this to one, and then we, yeah, stonks and stuff. Now what I also have done is breed the sheepies. Shear the sheepies. We have a little bit of wool going. This is nothing major. I don't think we will really need massive amounts of wool throughout this hardcore let's play. But a little bit we have. And we probably are going to use it for carpets and stuff. Because the deal with the honey is as follows. We can actually try this out over here. Let's say, whoop, can I hop over here? Yeah. Come on. Let me in. Thank you. Now, let's, for a second, rip out the floor. Whoop. Honey blocks have a certain, effect. You cannot jump on them. Well, you can jump, but not really high. Oh, wait, this might be a good way to get out. Ha-ha! Now let's see if we can put some fancy stuff in here. What color would be good for you? Maybe like a soap? Gray and white, and we can put that on top of the honey. Boop. Those guys will not be able to jump anymore. This is in particular good for situations like this, or even situations where you don't even want them to jump one block. Guys, would you move a little bit so I can place your carpet? Yeah. The sounds are a little bit disgusting, but okay, I can live with that. Now, they shouldn't jump anymore, and this is what we will definitely need for all of those buildings over here, from which we, well, will get a few going today. At least the smithy. The smithy, and also I think the cartographers stand here. I have something very special for them in mind. Also, I already have plans for those three buildings over here and the area for the fishermen, but I don't think I can do that in one episode. I'll have to split that in two. So, yeah, I think I'll do some final preparations. And then we should get going. And it's editing me here. Little intervention. We have a teeny tiny problem with the replayer today. I've basically recorded all the building sessions, but we have black screen in all of them, which is wonderful. So, yeah, no time lapses today. I'm very sorry. For the next recording session, I'll be fixing that. So, quick little update, guys. This is where the cartographers will be. It's a little bit wonky, I know. Well, the top is supposed to be some sort of canopy, which makes total sense in a cave. We don't do logic here. Well, Yeah, I like the look. Could also be some sort of, I don't know, muscle maybe, just being open with a pearl inside, here being the cartographer's table. Well, this doesn't need to be logical. This is just, I like it, period. Case closed. Now, moving the guys inside, something I will definitely do off camera because, yeah, well, in the last episode, you have definitely seen enough villager action. It is just annoying. There's nothing good about it. So, for now, I think I will put a little bit of greenery up here because the back seems to look, just looks a little bit blank. Next up is the smithy. Now, as you might have noticed, I have dug out a good bit of the ceiling. A good bit, actually. This is way higher than any other part of the cave. And I probably will dig out more, but actually I'm not sure where the mountain ends. I could be close to the surface, so we'll see. Yeah, but this build is a relatively big one, and it contains one little problem. That problem is copper. Now, I want the roof of this building to be oxidized copper, which means we will have to wait for it to oxidize and then wax it. Now, I have no idea how long that takes. Honestly, I don't. Especially not in single player. I've heard it takes quite the time. But I decided to build the building first and then just wait for the copper to do its job. It should be fine. I don't care if it takes a long time, if it looks a little bit off at the beginning. That is fine. So, let us get started.
Now imagine a fantastic time-lapse here, like top-notch time-lapse. First-class time-lapse. Yeah.
And it's coming together! Oh, guys. Wait, let me block up so we can see it from above. The orange, I hope you can envision that a little bit. This is going to be turquoise. And it's going to be looking awesome together with the brick and the deep slate. I think it really will. We get out of the way. So, the plan is for me at the moment to take a break because my head is steaming. I have to take a break. This is too much right now. So, for the moment, the interior is missing, but the outside is somewhat done. Well, except for the ceiling and the decoration therein. But this in here will get a really nice looking smithy, a forge. This will be where the toolsmith and weaponsmiths are in. I've shuffled them around a little bit because this here will be the armorsmith, who I think I will have less of. Because the tool and weaponsmith, I need more of to cover a bigger variety of items that they can offer. And this here will be for the stonemasons. This is basically one of the other spots where we can just get a load of emeralds for stone and diorite and stuff. And yeah, this will be awesome. So I'm going to head to bed and continue tomorrow. And I think I'm done? I think I'm done. Yeah. Take a look at this. Now, the smithy. The roof obviously going to oxidize and turn into green, so that will take a little while. But I managed to finish the interior. Well, not including the objects in the item frames. Or on the armor stands. Well, But I got all those guys in place, three armorsmiths, even though those two are reluctant to take on their profession. Three masons, which is awesome, and four toolsmiths. Now, I have zombified and de-zombified them all once. I would love to get that done one more time, but we are completely, and I mean completely, out of gold. We have 6 golden apples, which is obviously not enough for those guys. Yeah, that's a problem we'll have to address at some time. But, okay, that is, I guess, it for this episode. Let's finish it off with a little time lapse where I take care of the ceiling and the greenery. Okay? Okay.
Now, if you close your eyes and try real hard, you might be able to picture how this ceiling is made. All the greenery, the glowberries, the extreme amount of time put into the detail, the cobblestone, the mossy cobblestone, all the trapdoors and stairs and oh my god, the stalagmites and stalactites. I still don't know which one is which. Hours of work, such precision. And, oh my god, creepers in the corner, the action, the drama.
And I think that is it for today. Well, obviously, this is still far from complete ceiling-wise, but it takes a lot of time, takes a lot of concentration on my part, I think. It's really starting to feel like what I wanted this cave to be. Wait, let's find a better angle here. This thingy here is kind of in the way. Well, maybe from here. Should also be enough lighting to prevent any sort of hostile spawns. We'll see about that. Yeah, but that's it. And also, on a side note, of course, I couldn't just leave them like it. I leveled them up. And look at those trades. For one emerald, getting tools like this, this is just awesome. This is just really good. And I don't think I even have to level them, zombify them even further, because one emerald is as low as it gets. Also, those boys here, they have the brick trade, which is awesome because I love bricks. They have a little bit of terracotta that we can buy. Glaze, terracotta, quartz, all the good stuff. And those two, this guy here already is an armorer. Those two, they don't seem to want to take on their profession, which is a little bit weird. We'll see what I can do about that. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed this episode. Leave me a like if you did, and I'm going to see you in the next one, where we will take care of this stuff over there, the last parts of the cave, and then we're done here. Until then, see ya!